much the same way they did the first time. It was Cloud9 that was able to come up with that win when they played the TF Gangplank composition. It was with the Lee Sin in the jungle and a Kalista Soraka bot.
4-4-3 against 2-3-4.
Oh boy.
Teleport will double that number. This is gonna be it.
He TP's from the brush, so Balls is in the fight now. Rush getting a good tank on. He's out now. It's on to Balls.
Oh,
now Balls has
done.
To get out. Doing a great job of getting each other back and forth, but Balls can't get out in time.
Oh my. Out.
And he goes down as well. Retribution kill
here
coming in for Sneaky.
Bjergsen
on yellow. Three in favor of Balls, so doubling up there. Stand beside me going forward. It's actually going to be tapped onto
Jensen's
double lift first.
Yeah,
yellow start, level 5.
Here.
There's that Fate's call. Jensen behind the turret. High's going to take the tank. A lot of chaos in the back and forth here.
What?
But it looks like Hanser keeps the teleport coming in
Kids
late.
Are disjointed here. Cloud9 yep. grouped up.
There it is. Then they follow up. This is Yellowstar being 5. If Doublelift goes down first, that means he's left out to dry, and that's going to be another follow-up kill for Cloud9.
Matt plays Cloud9 again. Even
be on Cloud9's favor to start things off.
And that feels so good for Rush. He's already got the Devourer built for Kindred. Getting that immediate dragon is a huge burst of power because you get off to those very quick stacks for your Devourer, and it all spawned from him getting
Baron Pit, so to speak.
Teleport from Twisted Fate available. There
Whoa,
we go.
Oh, Sneaky's left alone. But then they actually go back because Jensen's on the other side. Jensen was really the help there to give Sneaky kind of a meat shield to get out of that one. And Cloud9 just absolutely turns TSM on their head after they try to go for Rift Herald and being spotted.
The Twisted Fate.
Ridiculous amount of global gold.
They
huge.
Have award in their jungle. This is, you do not want to use your Pulverize on high here.
That's not the first time they've done it. They will take him down, but it was quite a bit to take the support out. Bjergsen trying to move forward with
5 there.
It's true.
They do make the smart choice, though, and just sacrifice Hai's life.
Yeah.
Like, you know what? We'll sacrifice that Braum. That's fine. We'll
take my own direction.
Uh-oh.
And he
another
learned
teleport.
To take direction and calls this season. It's been working great for Cloud9. So is his kill.
Yeah, I mean,
there also are the added factors of Cloud9 have early leads so often. They can defend the pink wards they have, but Balls gets caught out now. Here comes Rush.
The cocoon. Orange, it's okay. Oh, of course you're going to try to 2v1. Ooh. There's the cannon barrage coming in. And that's going to be the extended fight. Rush versus Doublelift. He's forced to flash and heal out of this. Lamp the spike
man.
Goes down. That's a double kill for Rush. That's what they wanted, this composition, to get him out of the ult. But is it too little? Too late. Bjergsen falls as well. And now Yellowstar is going to be the next beef. He goes down. And that is almost the ace. Hauncer's on the other side of the map trying to add pressure, but it's Baron for C9.
That's definitely going to be Baron. And I am now confident saying I've been convinced of Rush's Kindred. Even though he had such a very strong early game start, you know, with the team playing really well, that right there was extreme confidence on Kindred, going very aggressive and earning that advantage for the team.
Cloud9's game to lose. Very much in the driver's seat here.
Good dodge, though.
Three now onto Balls. Looks like this one may finalize
him. Dodge one.
But Cloud9 is on the mid lane turret.
But the thing is,
it's a distraction.
An overcommitment there from TSM. I mean, everybody goes down. Bottom for Balls, and obviously the inhibitor is left exposed. Let's see if they get it or if they run.
They don't want to get caught in the base in a 5v4 situation.
It could be high. Sacrificial lamb once again.
Don't always get what you want.
Ooh, Sneaky with a very nice relentless pursuit to get himself into safety. And they're going to continue. Rush now going in. There's no turret. That's going to be a double kill for Sneaky. Looking for the triple kill coming in onto Hanser. He was in the other side of the map. And when he does come to the party, he's kicked right out.
Cloud9 starting this series off on a very, very quick pace here. We expected high tempo from them. And it looks like TSM just cannot keep up.
Yeah, their average game time in the regular season was 33 minutes and 18 seconds. This game's going to end much more quickly for them. And they are picking up right where they left off.
Jad, you said it before. The Twisted Fate, the Gangplank composition, it was back in week 6 when they took out TSM with it. They're going to do it again, 18-5, 25 minutes in. Cloud9 takes game 1 of the series.
Yeah, and if we hadn't been paying attention to the conversation among damage of Cloud9 very early in the game. And they're going to just have to work around Hanser's Maokai. Because that guy, if the game goes 45 minutes, will pretty much be unkillable.
The thing is, it's so hard to work.
Pushes up. But he's killing Gromp right now. Like, I hope he goes for him soon. Because this play has been a long time in the making.
And they do have
They
beam.
Know that
they
the
can interrupt Ball's teleport if Ball just tries to teleport out as well. Monster can save his smash.
He knows this is the fight. He's got to be baited in on this one. This is going to be first blood. Balls will be going down. It's going to take him a while, and the team's going to do what they can to add a bit more pressure. He almost takes out Haunter in the process. That's first blood, but with knowledge of the jungler top lane, they're going to go on a double lift, and that's going to be the assist and kills going over here to
the Azir being able to come over. This could
be an easy steal for him.
Yeah. But does he get more? Because Azir's here.
Oh, wow. TSM really working a few steps ahead here, thinking of the play before it really needs to happen. And I don't think this can even be closed on by Cloud9. That death mark is still down, so they're just using the regular abilities on this one. Svenskeren back in. Depth charge forces him out. And Yellowstar is trying to help him over the wall. Haunter gets a kill with Vengeful Maelstrom as he throws down the ultimate. And it looks like forced to back.
He was there before Jensen. Lucian comes in at the very end. And now they're going for Jensen.
Oh. Fate's call, and that could be it. He flashes as
well. That's five more on hit magic damage.
Yeah, he has two stacks of his Kindred passive as well, which isn't bad for 12 minutes.
Pretty much dead here in enemy territory.
Yeah, this is one of those
how long can you run for?
One of those secret missions gone horribly wrong, where they see you right as you walk in.
Oh, fancy.
Someone betrayed him. They gave him up.
So top lane push. Let's clean up in the mid lane.
Type of team that lets themselves get bled out. At some point, this game, like, this would normally be if this was a TSM.
You can just control vision across Baron side, Rush. I mean, we can take a break here and just watch this escape of Rush, or attempted escape.
His mark spawned in TSM's jungle, so he went for it.
There it is! Push
That's the displacement right there.
Trying to give Rush trouble, just at the grunt more than once. They were able to take the blue, which...
Yeah, you can't really repair. Just try and get more gold. Oh, there's that pick I was talking about.
Maybe dear.
They find a straggler. A lot of damage in return, though, so...
Very early on. Already, Rylai's coming through as the next item for Bjergsen on top of the Zhonya's, but...
Oh boy, that's Svenskeren. He seems to be still alive. Lamb's Respite goes down. Rush should be able to waltz out of this one. One last hit. Will not burn him down. He is fine there. It looks like Bjergsen actually is going to go down in this situation. The calling goes backwards. He flashes out. Svenskeren goes down, however. Bjergsen's used both. Fate's call comes in with the flash forward. And here's Ballstout to go down. What is happening in this fight?
That's what you
double
get.
Kill for Haunter. 9-4, 26 minutes in.
Bjergsen very low. They kill Svenskeren. But they also were very low. And instead of just running away, they allow Haunter to... And flash double kill him. Yeah. Away real quick. But Cloud9 again going for a fight because they see Maokai and Nidalee off to the side.
Oh, that's an interesting.
They got him.
Interesting call. Fate's call on the depth charge, but they're still going to be in the same spot as you group together on that situation. And Cloud9 actually being pushed back here. Svenskeren solo frontline on this guy until Haunter and Bjergsen get the soldiers up there, and they are still going hard on this. Nobody can even break Haunter right now. Bjergsen's running out of mana. This is going to be a tough fight to continue. Ball's now in range for all three, and they are just separating, picking and choosing, and surgically removing Cloud9 from the map.
That's how strong it is to have this full armor Maokai versus this C9 squad. They got demolished without Haunter even being there, but once he got there, even though it was they were outnumbered, they still turn it around.
Yeah, all carries were alive for Cloud9, and Haunter just did not care, walked straight into him.
Oh, that is
Cloud9's relenting, though. Oh, dear.
How you know when you've stayed too long?
Oh, dear.
Usually when you're dead.
Sneaky.
Usually when
you're dead. Oh, wait a minute, I got him! He got him!
You gotta be kidding me! Haunter fought in this. Another lane, a lot of things on the plate now for Cloud9 to think about during these fights. Jensen kind of fronts, puts himself up front there. Glacial Fisher goes out, but it's not where the team really gets stopped. TSM can free fight this and kite it backwards. The health bars are not looking good for Team Solomid as Cloud9 engages once again. Rush dead on the outside there. High about to go down. And now C9 has to turn tail and start to run towards the base. Haunter now with the initiation. He goes in and Svenskeren's more than happy to be his bash buddy. They're now onto balls. They're going to take him down. The turret will follow shortly after. I don't think Jensen wants to stand too close to the explosion.
The same thing. Cloud9 can all in before Haunter's there and burst down double if they do it a second time here. But the teleport is up, he gets there in time, and they're able to clean up. Again, TSM are very happy to sacrifice someone, literally anyone on the team, if it means that it's going to force a team fight with Haunter in the middle. As long as Bjergsen or Doublelift stays up and there's some DPS on the back line behind Haunter's tanking, TSM are happy to take that.
Yeah, it's just so hard for Zed to team fight against.
Oh, right to the Baron pit.
Azir kills it so fast, Kalista also secures it. The safest Baron rush you'll see. And
there it is. Is it the follow-up, though, onto high? He's the first one. It's fine for Haunter to be up front. Jensen going very, very low as he tries to 4v1.
Whoa, they got
Haunter! Nobody can get past the wall.
Hey!
Very interesting. Nice play, but Cloud9 still kiting this one out. Low HP bars on both sides here. Who's going to be the next finalized kill? There goes Sneaky, and that's going to be high falling as well. As soon as TSM can assess the fight, they get it the way they want it, and now Balls is going to try to flash away from this. TSM down the mid lane.
They killed that Maokai, though.
Yeah, they killed Haunter. It only cost them 4 kills on their
game.
Side.
It only cost them.
Ah, too bad. Anyway, TSM, that's exactly what they wanted to do. Force the Baron fight when they're that far ahead. Secure it very quickly. Even if they don't get the Baron, which was high likelihood that they would, they'd still be able to force an engage with the Maokai, and here we go.
What a clean game coming in from Team Solo Mid after a loss in Game 1 to Cloud9. We are all tied up here in the quarterfinals, 1-1, as TSM takes Game 2. There's mana, the resource pool, always in favor of Bjergsen here. We'll see if he uses that aggression in the early game. He actually was able to go off on Azir a little bit last time, with Svenskeren going quite hard in the lanes.
And also, they don't even have to switch Balls over to that side. Uh-oh, Jensen's out of mana and out of time.
Oh, Haunter, flash twisted advance. There's gonna be first blood. Haunter involved in that one. Did Doublelift get there too? He did.
Because he's always gonna be looking to juke back and forth, and that'll allow you to get into a range to at least spellcast. That's a lot of poke. He's gonna take the shadow.
Quite painful, the hits come in. Bjergsen's actually going for lane dominance. There's the kill coming in. Lamzer Spite's gonna get a quick save onto this one, invulnerable as it pops, and Jensen stays alive. The pressure here is gonna be Svenskeren, since that alt.
Should've finished that, but his pact was gonna run out, and now they're actually in a bit of danger of getting it stolen.
Uh-oh.
He's got Spite.
He's got it.
Please. Wait, why is
he has Spite. Didn't want to use it. Challenge, he's gotta challenge someone later. Use it on high.
All right, I think we're gonna fight here. Someone ring the bell. Okay, high flashes out, Rush stuck. He's gonna be able to vault over the wall. That's a repel and a flash from Yellowstar to as well. Carry Doublelift with a bit of speed. We see high going down on the Braum. That's a kill for Haunter. Rush is gonna fall as well. Jungler on jungler action. And now Haunter looks to pick up another one. Does he not have flash as he throws the ball?
Cloud9 have teleport advantage for this fight though.
Ooh, oh. Missed Shockwave.
That's a bye-bye, Jensen.
Oh,
one last hit, he's able to get the spin to win on, and it looks like they may be able to finalize the kill on Balls as well. Very low, high jumps in after almost losing Balls. He's trying to get the rest of the team in position to guard the turret, and he does.
With the Gangplank explosion of the barrels, even though he only has Trinity Force, whoa, Yellowstar again. I feel like we always have that moment in a TSM.
They were just setting up for the Dragon that was gonna be safe anyway because of the general positioning of the game. A small bit of gold back to Cloud9, but yet another Dragon and still control the TSM.
Anyways, as I was saying,
never mind. Duel, the Roa versus the Trinity Force.
Oh, that's a lot of pain.
Oranges versus Sapling.
Should have it here. There's the shot, the slow.
He doesn't know if he wants to go in or not.
Little trial by fire. See if he can heat it right under his toes. There's the burn. He's going for the kill.
Sapling.
Oh, doesn't get it that time. Someone finds out on a shutdown the Haunter, but Svenskeren not too happy about it. Also, not too much is going on across the map. A bit of a roam over from Jensen. He'll stop. Actually, bottom lane is a whole bucket of fun, and it's going to be one going down.
And then
you lose Sneaky, looking to lose high on this one, and they get the turret. Woo. You are very right, chat. Top lane is going to be Rush as well. Coast to coast. So we're going to need some body bags. Still looking to get kills around the board. Rush has those two kills right now, and Sneaky's going to be the next one. Just being too close every time has been the reason for somebody going flying around, slowed by Wolf. The flash prep to the wall.
Hello.
It's a big reach.
Holds the smash, letting the Twisted Advance lock him down for as long as possible. Very nicely done by Haunter. Now they have to look at the fight once again. Bjergsen ready to fly over the wall on the outside. And here's the bot lane.
A fight here. Bjergsen is behind Cloud9.
What's his target? He has Jensen. Jensen's shield is up. That's the exhaust goes down. He's left by himself. The double kill coming in for Bjergsen.
That should be Baron.
6-0-2 right now.
TSM are absolutely dismantling Cloud9 right now. Rush is making his way over with balls, but
they have Shockwave still. So if they wanted the full hero play, maybe. But they're so far behind here. The Shockwave, he doesn't have Zhonya's yet, but still dicey. Rush has Spike.
Oh, Yellow Star in the pit. He's going to take the AoE damage. He's going to be going down. So Rush picks up a little gold here, but it drops right out of his pocket into the hands of Double Lift. And they are just exchanging checks back and forth. TSM make out. 3 wins, 6 Ooh. Losses into what could be a quick quarterfinals against Cloud9. Here onto balls, he's not getting out of this one alive. And he will be going down quite fast.
Onto Svenskeren, there's 3 pink wards in the inventory of TSM. So they're going in, teleports behind him. This is the fight.
Face check of face checks. It looks like they get themselves to a somewhat safe spot, but that TP has already come in, and Cloud9's health bars are absolutely melting. Lambs Respite, the last thing saving them from being 6 feet under here. And there's a kill onto Sneaky, following up with Rush. Jensen is just barely with enough mana to keep himself in the fight. High is down, and now TSM runs for the fight once again.
Jensen is taking this Zedblade to the next level. A true ninja here. Everyone on TSM dodging that Shockwave as well. And he gets the kill on the exit with his Shadow.
And then Baron almost gets him again.
Baron's still pissed at him. Yeah. Baron hates ninjas.
Baron not a Bjergsen fan. Trying to kill him twice in a row here.
We'll have a little bit more free time. Bottom wave is just a few ways away from being on that turret right now, and they're going to go for the top lane. High should be going down here, saves himself with Locket and a little bit of defense.
Yep.
TSM is, they're hitting a brick wall here. They're actually looking for kills and not getting what they could be. This may be one of those kills they're looking for.
Yeah, well, Hanser is in. He's taking a lot of turret damage.
Monsoon.
The lead is there. Nice Monsoon there by Yellowstar to head off the rest of the Cloud9 team and keep them alive. No Infinity Edge.
He's 3 levels behind Double Lift, actually. So, really a big reason you're seeing him not even hurt.
This is a stomp at this point.
It really is. It may be 5 minutes slower, but it's consistent. Twice TSM has now done this to Cloud9. Definitely playing on their mentality here in the quarterfinals. A very strong first game and showing from C9, but they have not been able to find that yet again. And TSM will now be able to take 2 in a row, just 30 minutes on the clock this time, 23-4 in an even stronger fashion. TSM take game 3 of the series and look to go game point.
Yeah, they're now 1 win away from making it to the semifinals yet again after their worst regular season.
Graves, I feel like they keep it like this.
I think that's absolutely what's going to happen. TSM, again, has a very strong team.
Rush is already bottom.
They're faster.
This is what C9 needs. We've seen them having a lot of trouble if they get back in the early game in the Steadfast Presence level 2.
Massive outplay.
The package is looking. He's on a ward. That's a big gank.
Woo! Right over the wall. Bjergsen finds himself in a 3's a crowd situation when he thought he was only saying hi to one person.
Well, passive damage not going to help you there.
Yeah, get to an early game lead.
Nice ult.
Lambs Respite is up. He's going to try to walk him on the other end. He's going to hold it.
He loves using that Kalista ultimate in unnecessary situations. I think they could use that for a bit more pressure in mid, but they're going to be going for a turret there as well.
Oh my. Right onto Haunter. Nice tanking by High. The last to finalize the kill. He does get it.
So Haunter had a really good play. Long range pick champion.
Yep.
And they can look for more of those plays around mid where they try and snag people.
Whew. They're going hard right now. And he flashes out. Rush is going to be there as well. But I don't think Rush knew balls wanted out that much.
Uh-oh.
And now Rush is in a real bad situation. Not the first time as well. We saw instances of this last game. Collateral damage is going to pick that one up, but Cloud9
High's going for a roam,
though. Yeah, they're
going
to want this. They know his summoners are down.
They're going for the for sure kills here, and this one may not even be for sure. Tormented Soil and a Soldier able to pick that one up, but they have to go so hard, it costs them their life. Jensen goes down as Svenskeren picks that one.
Those ghosts I mentioned for Bjergsen have been completed. He's got his Frost Queen's claim. Bottom lane, though, they're just going aggressive.
Black Shield's there, though, to be used, and it's used for the Glacial Fissure. Easy to say. High could get rended out on this one. They have the collateral damage to finish off. If it doesn't, and it's going to be an end of the line for High as he gets taken down. And
so Cloud9 picked a global team composition to punish them not being able to make cohesive decisions. Then at the same time, come back to games 2 and 3, TSM picks very good early.
Yeah, everybody's bottom plus the top laners were backing off.
Yes.
So they're looking for teleports.
Oh, I mean, Double is near a dying turret, so you'd think they'd fight.
T TP coming in on one side.
Oh,
it looks like Poppy Balls has not moved yet. His has been stopped. That ward cleared out.
Whoa.
It looks like yes, or C9 gets cleared down on that one. Balls not coming through, kind of got me there. And now Cloud9 has to run for the hills. Svenskeren looking to finish an end of the line, but it hits the side of the turret. And it looks like they won't be able to finalize any more kills on this one.
Yeah.
Smoke goes down.
Talked about both top laners being able to interrupt each other. Balls went for the teleport, but Hauntzer canceled it. And
nice
now he's going to kill him.
Hauntzer
the ultimate right
up
top.
I can't get kind of repaired on it. Down the mid lane here, they finally got themselves a minion wave they might be able to work with.
Double lift is heading up the river. TSM might want to collapse on this one.
Yeah, they definitely do. The turret's down, but that doesn't mean the fight is not on.
Svenskeren gets a Soul Shackle by himself. They're ulting just single people here as they try to get their kills in. And then TSM comes back with a full team. Fates calls in, Fates calls out, and Double Lift flashes for the kill. Emperor's Divide pushes him back, but they're able to solidify that onto Jensen. And now they turn to Rush. Now they turn to Balls with Sneaky over the wall. They probably can't get him, but they'll finalize the Poppy, put him in the ground. And even when Balls can get to the fight now, he is just 5v1.
So good from TSM there, collapsing and outplaying in the skirmish around the second dying turret. But this Baron is really early.
Super early. Sneaky has his heal as well.
He's got
as
a big one.
I mean, they're killing the Baron pretty quick, and it would be 5v1.
Oh, no, use the big one yet.
How many rockets?
You better get in there quick. It's going down.
They get it.
Oh.
Kalista secure.
That's going to be the kill as well.
Well,
Kalista secure, Svenskeren secure, and Sneaky goes down.
All-star kill. He stayed in for the heal and then hopped out over to double lift. Definitely a ward to stick here for a while. Jensen goes in, though!
Huge. Oh, we actually
double
just
trapped
saw
on the package.
Sneaky go all the way back. They're trying to get a double lift. Gets cooked down on that. Sneaky low, but he's trying to find a way to get shots in from the outside. There's not much peel for Balls. High throws the binding backwards, and they may be okay.
Oh.
Gets the cask on it. High's going to get out of this one alive. Balls falls down again. The last guy to keep valiantly going down in these fights. As the team skitters.
Just push up mid. They tried to force that issue, but again, TSM out-team fought them with their goalie. That's going to be the mid lane inhibitor.
I have to say, the difference between Bjergsen's positioning and Jensen's positioning in the last couple of team fights has been huge. Bjergsen getting off so much of that long-range Vel'Koz damage. Right next to double lift, but he's running away.
I mean, double lift is just going to start damaging him.
These guys are holding hands here. Slow
later,
walk on the beach. Double lift gets thrown over the Baron wall. He's going to have to get back. Balls trying to go in. Another 4v1 situation. Gets taken down. The team cannot actually close it. And Bjergsen starts wiping people out with the laser recharge. Let's go in for another one, says TSM. And they're going to look for high. Here's the final attack. It's Svenskeren's. And they're going to have this turret.
Allowing them to put out the damage.
Oh, Jensen also trying to get some farm in the top lane. But Cloud9 is out of sorts. It almost feels like Hauntzer should get the slow.
Oh.
Here comes Svenskeren.
He basically negates the pushback of the Emperor's Divide by landing the barrel. Everything going right for TSM right now. The flash on high. All the defensive summoner spells being used, and they cannot be used to go aggressive on TSM, who's about to pull the trigger, ready to end this one. As they take down the second inhibitor turret of the game, 19-5, showing extremely strong in the quarterfinals.
Into the semifinals, you can almost forget what happened in the regular season a little bit as the sixth seed. Obviously, they could still have a lot of problems, but Svenskeren, that's a bad bind to get caught with.
He gets out himself. He can still kind of disengage the fight here.
This could be game.
Bjergsen with a good hit over the wall. Double it, very low, taking turret. He goes down. High is going to fall as well. And I believe, though, they do not lose Svenskeren over the side of the wall. They're still able to drop the TSM members. Everyone very, very low, though, as TSM pushes themselves to the limit on this second tier hit. Cloud9 was
But they've earned themselves that moment. 21 kills here, 10,000 gold lead almost. And they're going to be able to get that dragon very easily.
And at the back of our ground, and they're just going to keep going.
Fate's call goes in. They can even get Balls on the front line before they have to focus anybody else. Definitely a see hero, kill hero game for TSM. If they see it, they can take it down. And it's all disengaged for Cloud9 right now. Onto the inhibitor turret. They drop one more. They'll have minions pouring in through the top lane. And TSM looks to put on the final touches.
It is an Azir and a Corki to defend, but this is a strong five-man push. And they still have the Vel'Koz ultimate as well as a wave of super minions coming in. Yeah, but this could be it.
A quarterfinal matchup that had Cloud9 winning the first game. Rush trying to prevent the sweep. TSM coming back strong, though. Three consistent games in a row. and a bloody, bloody fourth game that they may just take it on. 23-6, 30 minutes into the game, Team Solo Mid take the quarterfinal match against Cloud9.
And what year is this? 2015, TSM would win the first game, win the next three. It's like, ah, it's a strategy, it's all this. But no, this was a completely different story and year for TSM. This was a 9-9 regular season team that had really been written off by a lot of people. Even Reginald, in his drive piece, said he's paying the price because this team didn't work out. But right now, against Cloud9, it worked out. And it's